Hey, what's going on, card collectors? Timmy F here with Field of Hoops and Dreams, showing off some of my cards I got this weekend, this Sunday in particular. Sports card show, Chicagoland area, Orland Park. It happens once a month. Certain months it happens twice a month, like this upcoming March. There'll be two dates, as you can see on the flyer in front of you. And also usually in December, they usually have two shows. There's actually going to be three shows in the Chicagoland area come March. You got March 8th. Sports Cards and More show, and also March 22nd. And I think that weekend on March 22nd at the Rosemont Convention Center where the National was held, they're going to have a huge sports memorabilia and card show there as well. I forget the Chicagoland Sports Spectacular. I think that's the name of it. You can Google that, find out more information. But here's the information in front of you for upcoming dates. If you're in the Chicagoland area, I met some pretty awesome dealers, guys that that were dealing there, that we actually submit our PSA subs to the same guy, which is kind of cool. And a lot of sports talk, a lot of YouTube talk about the drama with vintage versus modern. I think it's hilarious. I think there's room for everyone to collect what you like. For me personally, I like watching these players I'm collecting. And then I have a special bond with, obviously, the White Sox and the Red Sox. So I'll go after those vintage cards. But, you know, someone from the Minnesota Twins or, you know, Yankees or something like that. Like, unless it's Mickey, you know, I really don't have that much of a connection to. So I'm not really into the vintage. But anyway, that's just my opinion. And click what you want. You know, a lot of people aren't into basketball cards. And I am. I don't see too many YouTube channels doing basketball cards. But so I'm blabbling on here. Let's move on. As you can see, the hot product was Topps Series 1 from this year, 2020. And that was one of my goals, was I'm trying to get as many of the 1985 35th anniversary cards. As you can see in front of you here, you know, we have, these are just the pickups I've had. I got a bunch out of my jumbo box that I was really happy to have, and you know, I'm slowly crossing off the names on my checklist. And then I just want to bring up another card show that's coming up in April. If you're also in the Chicago area, it's out the western suburbs. I found this flyer there as well. So Brian DuBois is going to be there signing autographs. It's at the VFW in Morris, Illinois, just a little bit west and south of Joliet. If you're in that area, check it out. All right, on to the pickups. So here's my baseball pickups for the show. Here's a Devers Chrome Rookie. Pink Refractor. This is this year's Bregman Short Print. The technology that they're using with the Astros, isn't that interesting? I don't know if Topps did it on purpose or not. Just put these up alongside here. All right. Next is Alvarez. This is a Topps Choice. It looks like the Bowman style card, 56. Like, I spent, I think, $40 on all these baseball and basketball cards I'm going to show you, including the 85 ones here. It wasn't very much. They have great deals. I love going to this show when I have the chance. Another Alvarez, 85 rookie. Brendan McKay. Now watch out, this guy is going to be a sleeper, I think, this year. He has kind of like Shohei Ohtani, where he can DH and pitch. You see that by everybody's name. The Rays didn't use him that much last year. I think he played first base and pitched at some points. I remember watching games with him. But keep your eye on Brendan McKay this year for rookies. Here's a nice, these are the silver, see the hologram ones here? These are like the silver pack ones. I think two packs came in every jumbo box and one pack came in every hobby box, as opposed to the Alvarez one that is just plain here. To me, I like the silverbacks a little bit better for my PC. If I'm just getting the ordinary guys here, I'm just gonna get the plain ones, but I'll get what I can depending on the price. So this is for my Griffey PC. Here's the Trout one. Here is a Chrome Jeter. This is his last year. I think this is 17. 15. And it's his, obviously his game-winning home run he hit. Or game, I'm sorry, not home run. His game-winning, his walk-off single. Walk-off single from his last game as a ball player. And then, did you get your Mike Trout through the mail? Got this from Topps. Getting ready for the Top Now season, their fifth year. 25% off. I think it's funny that they sent it out, but I keep them. Part of the Trout PC. All right, and here's my basketball pickups. This is this year's Oscar Robinson Prism. I like the green variation. Goes with the uniform nice. This year's Luka Prism Base. I didn't have this one. I've got the green variation, and I've got the silver, but I don't have the base. I try to get the variations that go along with their team colors, because this looks sharp to me. 92 Upper Deck Jordan versus Magic. Remember in Lakers versus Bulls, the year Jordan won his first world championship. These are just some of Jordan cards I've been trying to reacquire since losing them as a kid, like we do with almost our cards. And here's a bunch of there's a North Carolina set that came out a while back. I'm sure maybe some of you have seen these before, but I'm trying to get these all back. These were like 50 cents a piece. I was like, and they're all in still good condition. Corners look good. Center may not be great, but the corners all look great. It's a sweet card. Man. All-Star Weekend was pretty awesome last past weekend, huh? I hope you guys watched it. Here's a 90s Hoops Jordan All-Star. 92-93 Flair Jordan base card. This is the same. This was in the playoffs, and this was the same as Jordan's Stadium Club that year. Same card. And MJ with his first trophy. This is Skybox. Here we've got a 88, I believe. Yeah, 88 Flair, Reggie Miller rookie. Really good condition. Corners are really great. Centering up and down and left to right to left are a little off. I'm still going to send this in for grading. I got this under $10. I'm going to send it in for grading and see what kind of grade I can get on it. But it's a great card to pick up. I think that's like almost $200 in a PSA 10. Here's a 1987 Fleer, Dominique Wilkins. That's a pretty sweet card. And these are hard to find. They were taken care of. Nice card there. Here is Optic Refractor, Tom Chambers. I was always a big fan of Tom Chambers when he played with Suns and the Supersonics, Seattle Supersonics. His auto was in a dollar box, so I've had to snatch that up. Here's another Anthony Hardaway, Flair Ultra rookie. This was also in a dollar box. Rising Stars. Had to pick that one up as well. Another dollar box, Marcus Smart. This is the 2013-14, I think. Yeah, 13-14. Rookie, he's playing excellent for the Celtics right now. 3-point shot is on fire this season. I love it. This is the red, white, and blue variation. I also have the green variation. I got one on auction on eBay. Here's an SP of Bird in his Indiana State Sycamores uniform. He picked it up for the Bird PC. And then Paul Pierce's Topps rookie, which I have a PSA 8 in his Chrome rookie from this year. And then lastly, I got a mail order in yesterday from eBay and... Yeah, these are all eBay ones, auctions that have been won. So I'm going to share these real quickly with you. Here's a Wendell Carter Bulls Red Ice rookie. I'm expecting big things out of him. He did really well in the Rising Stars game. It's nice to have some Bulls representing. Here's a Jimmy Butler. This is 2011-2012 Prism. Base, Jimmy Butler rookie. Corners look pretty good on it. Serene's just a little off, but that was a good pickup. Here's an Aaron Judge 2018 Donruss with the 1984 style logo with the All Rise. I'm not a big, huge Judge fan. I appreciate what he said about the Houston Astros recently in his comments. Maybe I'm going to start becoming a bigger Judge fan, but I think the All Rise from the Players Weekend, that's pretty cool jersey, so I had to pick that up. I'm not a big fan of the Donruss cards, but you know, this one is in particular is a nice one. And then here is a 1987 Flair Showcase. I actually got this one off of, I purchased this off of ComC. This is a PSA 9. These Showcase cards are really nice. Right now, Ray Rookie's a big fan of them. I actually saw this on his video, but yeah. It's a sweet card. Wasn't that expensive either. And then my last one is from YouTuber Lico 3. Man, and this is how you should send packages of someone in the team bag, everything perfect, protected by cardboard. Got his business card in there. I get a lot of people like just don't know how to pack their stuff, and I sell stuff on eBay and I try to take as much care as possible as well. But here's his YouTube channel and eBay. If you want to check it out. And then I picked up from him this 2000 Ultra, a PSA 9 King Griffey Jr. Flair Ultra. I thought it was a cool card. I was just scrolling through stuff for my Griffey PC, and I had never seen this card before. I just thought it was awesome. But yeah, that's it. I appreciate you taking your time to watch this. Hope you all are doing well out there. And remember, collect what you love, not what you need. And have a good one. Later.